He's starting off strong.
The coaches of Reug Reug have said that Oumar Kane has really developed the ground in all areas. Buchecha shot him for the takedown. Oumar Kane did a beautiful job of stopping that. Now he sits on top. Buchecha gets those hands locked. He's got that butterfly hook on one side. I think he's going to try to elevate and sweep.
Yeah, you see Oumar Kane like pulling his hips back there, trying to maintain his base and balance. He's able to pull his hips back, then he can work that underhook back in. But Buchecha is amazing with these butterfly sweeps.
And good a float over from Kane to maintain that balance. Everybody's been calling Kane one of the freakiest athletes on the face of the planet. And he's got one of the best jiu-jitsu practitioners underneath him right now as he's working his way into side control.
Reug looking to overwhelm Buchecha.
Swinging for the fences here. Confident on the feet. Good head movement. Buchecha needs to look behind that jab.
Buchecha's gotten blasted with some right hands from the Senegalese wrestling star. A takedown. Good tap for Buchecha.
Good wizard kick right there from Kane to maintain that top position. Erdin giving Kane a stiff warning about grabbing the shorts.
But Buchecha is so strong in the clinch and with his grappling ability. For Reug Reug, he is a star in his Western African nation of Senegal.
This is a smart strategy here by Buchecha. Slow down the pace a little bit, push on Kane, make Kane push back. Make Kane use that gas tank. It's a lot of muscle, it requires a lot of oxygen. I would do my best to take Kane into those deep waters. Don't get caught up in that storm at the beginning. Let Kane punch himself out.
There's a left hook for Reug Reug.
I don't know if Kane was aimed for the shoulder. I don't know if it landed. I couldn't see it from this angle. If it did land, Herb should have been on top of that.
You can need the head of the ground at a point, but you can't soccer kick no more. I've been on the receiving end a couple of those. It sucks.
An inverted triangle attempt coming up for Buchecha here. Can he pull it off? If there's one guy to do it, it's Buchecha.
Kane needs to remain calm. This is a bad spot for him. Buchecha's going inverted. Now he's looking after the leg. Transitions. Tanasha Garami, he's still got.
Buchecha does a good job there clearing the knee out. But Kane does a good job of clearing the knee out. This is a very high-paced match between two heavyweight fighters.
Yeah, they are pushing a serious pace, Rich. It's gonna come down to the gas tank here in the last 90 seconds of this round. Yeah, he's got the confidence in their gas tank to really start to push right now.
These two guys are moving like they're bantamweights or flyweights or something.
Guys, this is what you get with the world's leading martial arts organization, ONE Championship. Two heavyweights that move like they're bantamweights.
Mixed martial arts in this legendary Lumpini Stadium is truly something special, Rich. Good job by Oumar Kane to control that foot.
Keep those clean.
Looks like he's going to the back of the head.
Keep those clean.
Under a minute left, Herb Dean saying to keep them clean.
Buchecha's eating some shots.
They both are exchanging on the feet. Buchecha's bleeding. This is the first time Buchecha's faced adversity in his career.
Good knee to the body by Buchecha.
His clinch, his face is getting busted up, but he continues to come forward.
That right there is a movement of fatigue on Buchecha's part. Kane, he kind of threw a punch and hit a slide by, and just, you can see that there's exhaustion on this side.
Buchecha's hurt. Buchecha getting overwhelmed, but he's fighting fire with fire.
Buchecha
looking for the takedown of Khan. What a battle.
This is amazing.
Buchecha's got to move. He's got to move. He's got to get in. Oh, he pulls guard.
He'll survive this round. Around.
Buchecha.
You can go. 5-6. You can go.
Buchecha going to the body with the kicks. That's a smart adjustment right there. Really start to wear on that gas tank of Khan.
Right now we are into the second round. Scheduled for 3. Buchecha looking to try to turn things around in grand fashion. But Khan very much determined. There's a right hand by Buchecha.
Chin is getting tested. Khan is throwing heat. Gets in on the single this time, though. Turns the corner. Puts Khan on his back.
That is fatigue set in on that scroll right there. And you do not want to have Buchecha on top of it. This is exactly what I was talking about in the first round, weathering that storm.
Now Buchecha teeing up on Khan. Oh my goodness, Buchecha looking to finish things off here against Khan. Can he do it? What a turnaround.
He went to that half guard, Mitch. He talked to us about that earlier this week, looking to isolate that arm so that he can land these strikes.
He likes this position right here. Buchecha does good ground and pound from right here. Oumar Khan scooting out the back door, though.
Yeah, you got to be careful with a guy like Oumar Khan, because even though he's tired, Buchecha's mounting here, but even though he's tired, you just have to be careful, because he can always muster up one explosive motion to get himself out of a bad situation.
This is the perfect position for the arm bar. He's giving it up right there. Here it comes.
And Khan, is he trying to get out of it? Can he do it? Buchecha trying to isolate that right arm of Khan.
Looks like Khan might be safe right here. He's got the elbow clear. Yep, he's good.
I know how badly Buchecha wanted that arm bar. I think he would have played safe and kept that topside position. As we always said in my camps, position over submission.
Guys, this fight has been all that we expected and that much more. Coming up on under 2 minutes to go in the second round.
The last 2 minutes of this round are all going to come down to sheer will and fortitude. You got to dig deep when you're in these situations, man.
Jeff!
A beautiful job on the sprawl that time.
Khan is busting up Buchecha. Buchecha had moments of brilliance, but then Khan was able to turn things back in his favor. Under 90 seconds remaining in our second round.
In the state of this match right now, with the amount of energy that both of these fighters have expended, this is not a match where you want to be on bottom. Buchecha rolling the guard right there just puts Khan on top, and even landing these little body-body head ground-and-pound combinations that's not going to finish the match. He's not highly mobile here, Buchecha. And in this case, it's like Khan is just going to be able to score. If you're going to shoot him for something at all costs, at this point of the match, you need to make sure you end up on top side position.
Rich, but you know as well as I do, when you're in the fatigued state, you resort to what's comfortable, and the guard is very comfortable for Buchecha. I don't know, maybe you don't get fatigued when you fought back in the day, but I sure did, and you resort to whatever's comfortable, and the guard is very comfortable. You can see just how relaxed he is, and he's also given the chance to get his breath back as well, but he's also given that same chance to Reug Reug.
Yeah, I think Reug Reug was, even this little bit here, Reug Reug is on top of Buchecha, so in some sense, even though the bulk of Khan's weight is on his knees on the mat, he still has to carry some of it on top of him. So as these two are recovering from this position, in my opinion, Reug Reug is recovering much more. He's in a more comfortable position.
And he's also doing damage and scoring as well, which leaves a good look in the eyes of the referee and the judges when this thing goes to the third round. Even if he's a takedown.
Well, I'll tell you, the lesson that both these guys have taken out of this match is they're going to question how they are training their conditioning moving forward, because this is 15 minutes of both of these guys pushing a lot of weight around.
So is this a must finish for Buchecha against Khan here in this third and final round?
Absolutely not. And this is our global MMA, and in these MMA rules, we judge a fight in its entirety. So, Buchecha now has the back. kick here, he could do a lot of damage and end up winning this fight, even if he is unable to get the submission. So it is possible, you know, Khan is not that far ahead on the scorecards, in my opinion, that he needs the finish to win.
Oh, wow, Buchecha gets peeled off the top by Khan. Now where nobody really gets out of that position with Buchecha. But they're all so slippery. You know, they're a little bit fatigued, didn't quite have the grips that he wanted to, but Buchecha did a beautiful job on that takedown when he didn't quite have the double leg, but to duck under, scoot around, and take the back.
Yeah, Mitch, it was clear that Khan, his entire team, they said he hasn't even realized the full potential. Big right hand by Buchecha there as we near the 3-minute mark in this third and final round.
Buchecha up on the single leg, pulls guard again, but runs right into some hammer fists thrown by Khan.
When he shot in on that leg and had that single, it was really, in my opinion, do or die there to either retreat from that or come around, get that underhook, come around the backside, try to get the back, rolling underneath for, in this half guard position. You just, both of these guys are tired. You're too tired to execute any kind of reversal on an opponent. Rugrug's size, like to elevate that kind of weight and get that reversal is very difficult at this stage of the fight. Not just with fatigue, but with the fact that they're both sweating, they're both slippery.
And especially in the previous rounds, we saw some beautiful floatovers from Rugrug when he was elevated in those positions. So his balance and awareness of himself in space is remarkably sound.
Yeah, thinking about this, it's like one of these two guys, whoever wins this match, and it's really running away from Buchecha at this point in time. He's got 2 minutes. And back to your question, Ray, before, we're at that point now where Buchecha may need to actually finish this fight. Like, I don't think he can get enough done in 2 minutes if he was to completely dominate. But the question I'm asking myself at this point is that one of these two guys may end up meeting Malakin in a 5-round match. And I know that Malakin has the gas to go those 5 rounds.
Well, you know that Malakin, the world champion, is watching this one intently as we have 100 seconds to go in the fight.
Good control from Khan on top here. Utilize that 9-pound control in the handcuff positions.
Stop. I saw you. No. Get up. No, yes, get up. I will disqualify you. Get up. I saw you. You don't tell me what I saw. Come on, stand up. You grab it inside the glove.
Hurricane and Miles Shane Khan. And now Buchecha's got an opportunity here. They're going to the top of the table. Here in
America, it's Moonlight Night 13. Buchecha knows that it's do or die right now. And he's just got to put everything on the line. He's catching some punches, but he's delivering some punches as well. These things are landing. He's got to get this top side position. He's got a minute to work here to finish this match. He is in a position where he needs to, in my opinion, finish this match. Oumar Khan cannot skate this out. If he's able to get through this minute, he will likely win this decision. Herb Dean was warning them because...
Stop!
Grab the shorts again. He grabbed the shorts again. That's going to be a yellow card right there.
He had warned Rugrug before because Rugrug had laced his hands inside of Buchecha's gloves, and Buchecha was complaining about it. Now we have another situation. Herb Dean is going to issue the yellow card.
Herb Dean warned him several times, took away the position because Oumar Khan was digging into the gloves of Buchecha, and that's why he stopped them. That's why that little argument happened about a minute ago when they started teeing off on each other. But now Herb Dean is going to issue a yellow card. Was he warned Khan about?
Grabbing the shorts, grabbing the gloves.
And keep in mind with this, the yellow card can play into the judge's decision, but it's not like a 10-point rest system where you lose a point. And this just stopped the momentum that Buchecha had there with that top side, you know, that grounded position.
Well, now Buchecha has 40 seconds to try to turn things around. This is the most adversity. He's down with an overhand right over the top for Khan. What a battle here at the historic Lumpini Boxing Stadium, an iconic venue known for its litany of historical showdowns. Can Khan get the biggest win of his career and win over the 17-time BJJ World Champion, Buchecha.